Hardly a sport of the present day better expresses the Olympian spirit than winter sport, because with its boundless treasure of strength, health and beauty, it can give to all mankind joy and restitution. The starter calls the girls to the starting line for the ladies' special slalom. Gretchen Fraser of Washington leads off. Erika Maringer of Austria. Rose Hammerer, also of Austria. Andrea Mead of Vermont. Georgette Miller-Thiolier, running for France. Celina Zeghi of Italy. It was a great moment in the life of these three girls as Trudy Weiser receives the gold, Gretchen Fraser the silver, and Erika Maringer the bronze medal for the combination of downhill and slalom. Greater yet was the joy in the American skiing community when Gretchen Fraser stepped up to be acclaimed as the new 1948 Olympic slalom champion, with Antoinette Meyer of Switzerland in second place and Erika Maringer of Austria in third position. This victory, the first occasion in the history of skiing for America to receive top honors, made it a day to be remembered. From the snow fields to the ice rink where Kapp of Czechoslovakia is competing in the men's freestyle. Eddie Rada of Austria. James Krogan of the United States. Thank you. But the ice that day belonged to just one man, Dick Button. Dick was a popular winner, well liked by everyone. Happy boy and a proud father. This may look like some historic retreat. Actually, it's thousands and thousands of jumping enthusiasts making their way towards the Olympic Hill. They came on foot, by car, by sleigh, in buses and on skis. 49 jumpers in all, representing 14 nations, competed amid trying conditions. The snow was tricky and the visibility poor. This combination demanded the utmost in jumping skill. Musicians needed to unfreeze their instruments, and the resulting music fairly melted the snow. The hill required some last-minute attention. Then, one after another, like human arrows, the 49 men shot through the air. In spite of conditions, very few falls occurred. The Norwegians' old hands at this sort of thing carried away the first three places. This is world famous Asbjørn Rud. He finished in seventh place. Gordon Wren of Colorado in a brilliant leap of 206 feet. Gordon finished an excellent fifth. This is Torleif Schjelderup of Norway, who took third position. Two-time Olympic winner Birger Ruud barely missed his third gold medal as he finished second. Here is one of the less fortunate in one of the few falls. No harm done. Number 35 brings the jumping to an end. And so, all the medals went to the country where jumping originated, Norway, the home of Petter Hoogstad, Birger Ruud, and Thorleif Schjelderup. Now the retreat is on. After snow comes sunshine. The cameras are trained upon the ice rink. The judges get their final instructions. Everybody is here. The queen of the ice, Barbara Ann Scott. No other form of competition requires the training, willpower, self-sacrifice, and physical stamina as does the 50-kilometer cross-country race. This 32-mile endurance test is the toughest sort of grind, even for a hardy Swede or Finn. Here at the halfway turn, after 16 miles, with another 16 to go, we see the leaders within 1 to 3 minutes of each other's time. Niels Karlsson is in second position, with a time of 1 hour, 49 minutes, and 49 seconds. Leading the field by 1 minute is Harald Eriksson, number 28. Carlsson puts on the pressure at the 28-mile mark. Back at the finish, Anders Törnqvist crosses the line in fifth position. He doesn't give the appearance of having gone 32 miles. Benjamin Vanninen of Finland takes third place. This is Harald Eriksson of Sweden coming in second. And Niels Carlsen, the winner, 32 miles in 3 hours, 47 minutes and 48 seconds. On downhill day, everyone headed for the top of the mountain. There was expectancy and excitement in the air. The patrol gave the course the final once over. The first eight toboggans took their posts. The four runners flash by. The big race is on. Gutte, a red-hot favorite, was number one. To the top of the Schuss, he was clocked at 1 minute, 53 seconds. Two turns, and he pointed them down. Over the bumps. Through the woods. Into the finish. His time, 3 minutes, 7.6 seconds. Mall of Austria was 1 second slower at the Schuss. He was 2 seconds behind Gutte at the finish. Johannesson of Norway falls. Alvero of Italy gains 2 seconds. He is obviously faster. His time, 3 minutes, 2.4 seconds. 5 seconds to the good. Hansen of Sweden looks white. He had a fall. Next should be the Swiss Molitor. The excitement is terrific. Can he beat Alvero's time? Here he is, 2 seconds ahead at this point. Can he hold them? his final time? Yes, 2 seconds better. Now comes Oreiller. It's unbelievable. 4 seconds ahead of Molitor. He gains another second and finishes with a time of 2 minutes and 55 seconds. Nogler of Austria follows. One by one they try to better the flashy Frenchman's time. Bonnie McLean of Colorado. Hollinger, Switzerland. Grosjean, Switzerland. Chironi, Italy. Steve Knowlton of Colorado catches an edge and takes an egg beater of the first magnitude. But he is game and is off again. Jack Reddish comes full speed, makes a one-legged turn and gets away with it. Nice going. Lucky boy, Jackie. Gabel, Austria. Hans, France. Sponar, Czechoslovakia. Spada, Switzerland. Schöpf, Austria. Bob Platt, California, takes the shoes beautifully. Midway, he picked up some snow and left the pole. Carlo Gardner, Italy. It was a strong and brilliant victory for Henri Oreiller of France. The Austrian Franz Gabel was an impressive second. Popular Molitor and Hollinger tied for third. Once again, the skies opened and gently the white fell upon the closing ceremony, covering man-made tracks throughout the area as if to restore peace and quiet and return the countryside to its original setting. And so end man's most gigantic games. made a symbol of this flame, remain burning fiercely and light the future. A future of understanding and fair play among all men the world over.